In this video, we'll explore how to add PWA capabilities to a .NET 8 project using bswup. First, let's delve into the benefits of PWAs. We'll utilize the demo applications to do.bitplatform.dev and adminpanel.bitplatform.dev. A significant benefit of incorporating PWA is that even when the server is unavailable or the user's internet connection is interrupted, your application can remain accessible. The user will be promptly notified of the situation using the UI/UX of your choosing. As illustrated in this demonstration, the program not only attempts to reconnect to the server up to 3 times, waiting for potential resolution of network issues, but also provides a clear and concise error message in case of persistent connectivity problems. Furthermore, by employing tools like bswup or similar ones and having a client-side database, you can even save your desired changes while offline and synchronize them upon connecting to the internet. Thirdly, it is possible to implement an effective HTTP cache policy, such as caching all static files for up to 7 days without requiring conditional GET requests. Typically, static files are not cached, or even if they are, each cached file triggers a conditional GET request to the server before being served. If the conditional GET request receives a status code of 304, not modified, the cache is used. This practice can negatively impact application startup time and introduce unnecessary server load. However, Blazor typically only covers changes to DLL files, meaning that modifications to JS, CSS, or PNG files can hinder effective HTTP caching. PWA, on the other hand, addresses this issue by having the entire assets list, including, but not limited to DLLs, CSS files, PNG, and SVG files. Providing each asset with a unique hash value that is sent to the browser ensures that the browser only retrieves the most up-to-date version of modified assets only. If you utilize a CDN, you will need to purge the CDN cache when you make changes to assets, as the CDN cache will also store a copy of the assets list. The fourth advantage lies in the synergy of combining PWA with pre-rendering, offering distinct benefits over pre-rendering without PWA. Generally, pre-rendering proves advantageous for search engines and provide a seamless experience for users during their initial visit when essential files may not have been downloaded yet. However, in subsequent visits, pre-rendering tends to become more of an additional load on the server. The inherent nature of PWAs, wherein they don't rely on the server to open the web app after activation and are independent of the established network, contributes to their efficiency. Once activated, PWAs load the web app directly from the browser's cache, minimizing the need for repeated pre-rendering. Consequently, this process alleviates the burden on the server. Prominent examples of this approach include Reddit, GitHub, and Facebook. PWAs also provide granular control over updates. Unlike non-PWA web applications, PWAs allow you to set update preferences, enabling users to approve updates manually, which can be valuable for certain business scenarios. Additionally, the update process occurs in the background, ensuring seamless startup transitions. Moreover, PWAs offer the flexibility to open on a dedicated page, create shortcuts for specific pages, publish them on the Microsoft Store, and launch at system startup, among other compelling features that enhance user experience. I have created a Blazor app project with its Blazor mode set to auto. As mentioned earlier, the PWA encounters no issues with our chosen approach, whether it be Blazor server, WebAssembly, or auto, with or without pre-rendering. You can find the link to the project in the video's description. Then integrate bswup into the client project and incorporate the required tags. Additionally, introduce service worker file into the system. Enhancing the user experience, it is advisable to include a program icon and integrate both the manifest and service worker files. The manifest file, in conjunction with the service worker, forms a pivotal aspect of progressive web applications, and extensive documentation is readily available on the internet for reference. The service worker file associated with debug mode remains empty. This is intentional, as caching files during this mode can significantly compromise the quality of your development experience. To ensure the proper functionality of your PWA during testing, either publish from the project or manually populate the service worker file with the content from the published service worker. Typically, you wouldn't need to concern yourself with service worker settings, but one crucial aspect involves server-handled URLs. By default, when a URL is entered into the browser address bar or a redirection to web app takes place, the app receives that URL. Importantly, doesn't wait for the network to connect or for the server to respond. bswup defer to the server for handling requests to URLs that are included in the server-handled URLs. Moreover, in line 3, change the CSS file name to reflect your project name. You might argue that such a file does not exist in your project, and that is indeed the issue. The assets list generated by .NET incorrectly includes the name of a file that does not exist, and you should exclude it from the list. By default, upon the release of a new version, it discreetly initiates the download process, and its progress is visually represented by a circular indicator at the top of the screen. You can customize the appearance of the update download progress bar by modifying its styles. Alternatively, you can disable automatic updates and present the user with an update button for explicit control over the update process. To enhance the web app's overall performance, modify the middleware for static files and implement the preferred caching policy. Before delving into the review of AppRaiser, it's crucial to bear in mind that the primary document of the site is cached. This ensures that the web app can be accessed seamlessly in any situation without the need to connect to the network or wait for the server to respond. If this document is the result of pre-rendering, its content can contain whatever you've put in your pages, such as the current system time or the title of the page and more. Moreover, the PWA will consistently display the same page in subsequent user visits, which can be deemed illogical. Therefore, it becomes imperative to cache the non-pre-rendered version in the browser. The process of achieving this is facilitated by the bswup, which signals the absence of pre-rendering by appending the no pre-render parameter in the query string. For the first user visit, when PWA is not activated, you have the option to choose between Blazor Server, Auto, or WebAssembly, with or without pre-rendering. Utilize this render mode for the head outlet and routes. Additionally, introduce the manifest and set the auto start script for the Blazor web to false. Include the bswup scripts and also incorporate a progress bar. Now, for testing, simply publish the project and open it in a browser. Firstly, effectuate a modification in the web application, proceed to publish it, and reopen it. You will observe that the automatic update has been successfully applied. To deactivate the automatic update feature, simply return to the application's progress bar, locate the auto reload setting, set it to false and uncomment any associated comments. Please note that, as this page is an integral component of your web app, users will observe the changes upon updating to the new version during their next app update. If your objective is to collect and store data from users when the web app is accessed offline, allowing for synchronization upon reconnection, one viable option is to employ Entity Framework and SQLite. In this context, be sure not to overlook the informative bswup video segment. Additionally, you can embark on the Platform 101 video series, which includes training on the boilerplate project template. This template offers numerous capabilities beyond PWA and offline databases, including dark and light theme support, multilingualism, and many other intriguing possibilities. Furthermore, it produces Android, iOS, Windows, and macOS apps with complete access to operating system features and the ability to utilize third-party libraries written in Java, Swift, Objective-C, Kotlin, as well as web output with pre-rendering and PWA capabilities. In essence, it enables you to produce all these outputs with a single code ACE.